What is up, Honey Badger Nation? This is John Kitchens, and this is episode 99 of Expert Mentors Live. I'm very excited for today's episode as we have the queen of staging, Jana Usselton, on, and we're going to talk about virtually preparing homes for sale with online assessments. So, Jana, say hello to the Honey Badger Nation.
Well, hello, Honey Badger Nation. I'm super excited to be here with you today. Thank you, John, for having me.
Yeah, thank you for making the time and jumping on with us. And I know, you know, the information that we're going to bring to everybody is really, really relevant, especially to kind of the landscape of things these days. So I'm really excited to jump in, and I know you're going to contribute massive value. So before we jump in, give everybody a little bit of info, background about yourself.
Yeah, well, you know, we started in this whole home staging journey back in 2002 here in the Dallas-Fort Worth area. We actually had our own property that would not sell when it was empty. We had an immediate offer, moved out, the offer fell through. We didn't know what to do. We were paying two mortgages. By this time, we were stressed out, and I asked the agent, what if I bring some things back into this property so it's not so empty? He said home staging. I'd never heard of it. I tried it. It worked. And the rest was history. I mean, I jumped into training. We literally hit the ground running. Mike Reese was one of the first realtors that I went after. He was young, you know, early 20s, just rocking and rolling. And it was pretty awesome to see his business thrive here in the area. And, you know, he was one of my first mentors. He said, you've got to read Ultimate Sales Machine and duplicate yourself. And I took that advice, and we're one of the largest home staging companies in the country. We have a team. It literally runs without me, and I've been able to focus on building a home staging community throughout the country and just helping them grow a business by sharing what we did wrong. It's been a great journey.
Yeah. And it's kind of cool, you know, as Mike's business was starting to take off. I mean, it was just perfect timing for you, you know, just how well that aligned and really, you know, help get a jump start. And you know, I know you were a tremendous, for us, right? We even brought our team out of Lawton down, and you helped, you know, train and you know, really then obviously the opportunity, you know, for Holly to come on board. And it was, it's been a pretty cool journey for sure.
It has. We have loved, you know, just being part of the family and helping each other grow. It's just been amazing journey.
Yeah, absolutely. So let's, we can jump in wherever you kind of want to. I really, you know, I think everybody is like, yeah, we get it. Staging. Yeah, we know. It's almost like, it's like just kind of what happens now, right? It's nothing. It doesn't seem like it's that special anymore for them. Like, oh, we're going to stage. Oh, what's that? Right. And you're able to go through, but, you know, definitely the power of staging versus not staging, and then also getting into, you know, the virtual side of things and how you guys are you know, operating and you know, doing those online assessments and moving forward.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, we've all had to pivot in our business. And one thing about home staging, you're right, it was kind of one of those things that was, you could take it or leave it. You know, it's just one of the processes within the step of home preparation. But what we're learning today is home staging companies are way more than just home staging. It's really about creating a marketing firm that helps the agent, helps that seller really prepare, right, beginning, middle, and then end, and really passing the baton back to the agent once it is ready for market, but then also staying engaged on the back end of helping promote and market that property once it is live. And so I would just say, you know, for the Honey Badger Nation out there, really understand that home staging is way more than that. When you partner with a company, you're really partnering with a marketing firm. And home builders actually have the line item of home staging under marketing whenever they're budgeting for us, because they know that we're doing way more than that's just one of the processes is coming in and actually, you know, setting up furniture or helping that seller. But we've had to pivot these last several weeks. Now, the good news is we were already on that journey. We created Review My Listing, and we wanted people to be able to have an option to do an online assessment, and so that we didn't have to waste time driving all over. You know, time is money. So how can we do an assessment literally virtually on the home by having that seller just fill out a Q&A, snap a few pictures, do a quick little video, send it in to us, and we can literally rate that property, get them back a report in real time so that they can start the process of, because many times when it's an occupied home, it's really it's a partnership. They need to do a few things, and then we can come in and do things or help them DIY the project.
Yeah, let's unpack that. I mean, it's fantastic hearing, you know, we've all had to make some adjustments and make some pivots and do some things. So I think that's really valuable for everybody listening in. What, what can the agents do, you know, besides reaching out to you? There's a couple other questions that I want to be able to give to everybody what to look for, but what is that virtual assessment? I mean, like let's really unpack that for everybody.
Yeah, that's a really good question, because we know, John, that these top agents are already walking through property, building rapport. They're meeting. Now, this was, of course, yesterday. We'd go in, shake hands, sit at the kitchen table, like really build the connections there, try to earn that listing. And part of that process is getting up and literally, show me your house. Let's go take a tour. And hopefully they weren't giving away everything on that little quick tour of what they need to do. And then that seller go list with someone else. So it's really about knowing when to share the information, when to do the agent assessment on the property. But now we have to take that virtually. So how do agents really get eyes on the property and give them feedback so that they can do, at least at a high level, start the engagement process? And the cool thing is it can all be done online. A lot of our stagers are doing a FaceTime video and doing the walkthrough. But as a realtor, I would say, you know, whatever you've had to pivot to of earning a listing today, you can literally assess the property online. But if it's not written, it's not real. It's just information, and people will remember about 10% of what you say. That's always been a challenge in our industry. So we wanted to create, you have to have a report, you have to have something that they can refer back to. And then it will hopefully help happen quicker, you know, when you can set some expectations, set some deadlines, and they know exactly what that expectation is. So there's tools out there that you can do an assessment with. We've got them in our staging community. We have created things for agents to be able to use. And it's just one of those things, whether it's literally an old school report that you're sending them, a couple of bullet lists. But I would say if agents, just to up the game, if they could just get those assessment actions that they're trying to give them, they want them to do, that they feel like are the priorities, get them written down so they can follow, you know, the homework assignments. But whether it's like using FaceTime, whether it's doing Zoom and just walking through, or then like uploading a few pictures or sending you a less than 10 minute video, however they can get that to you. And then at some point, the agents really need to do an assessment of a written report and give them that plan.
No, I love that. And, you know, the power of you know, bringing you in, or bringing, you know, if you have a stager already in, it's that outside voice, right? The agent isn't the bad guy, right? It's like, hey, you know, you guys need to do this. It's like, the sellers are like, what? You ain't like, what are you talking about? But when you bring in, you know, that third party that the professionals of that, and then they give that professional assessment, and then you can then say, hey, here's our checklist, you know, and then you can go through the whole commitment process. What are some of the things that you guys are seeing that you're recommending that should be like, hey, these are kind of the you know, the common things that we see that we know that the sellers can do without, you know, like your professional team coming in. So little more backstory before I let you answer that is that when we had the brokerage in Dallas, we actually, part of our process was what would we end up calling like a 2-hour touch up, to where we would send stagers in on every one of our listings, and they would actually put their hands on what is going on. Because what we found is that when you request the sellers to do things, they don't do it. So I'm curious, with what you're requesting and what you're wanting them to do, how do we know that, are we giving them action items that we know that they'll do?
Yeah, that's a really good point. And one thing that we'll share with you guys is as a free resource. And I do want to hear some comments, because I'm part of the Honey Badger Nation here, EXP agent as well. Not practicing, but I'm part of the family. And I want to know, like, what are your top things that you literally have to repeat that you say to these sellers? We have a checklist because we felt like a broken record. So we created a short list. We'll get that to you guys as a free resource. It's ours. Awesome. Y'all can rebrand it. You can use it. But, you know, it's the same thing. And we've all seen the crazy houses. We've all had, like, do I really need to tell you to clean? Do I really need to tell you to take this down? And you know, that's a whole book too, what all we've seen. You know, from the stripper pole to the naked bra, you know, wife above the bed, the portrait, like, what is going on here? Okay, but anyway, apart from that, the typical things that we have to tell people is, you know, the common sense stuff. When you're preparing a product for market to be sold and you want top dollar for it, you know, let's do a spring cleaning. Let's do a make ready. We got to start there. You know, make sure that all of your projects are finished. Your little honey-do list is finished. And then we're letting people know to keep it simple. You know, let's pre-pack the collections. Let's make sure that we have we have our artwork on primary walls and not secondary walls. And primary walls are the walls that when you first enter a room, what's facing you. So we really want to think about that. If you have too many pictures, then the buyer's saying, I have to repair walls. That's not a good thing. We want to show maximum storage space. We want to make sure that in that property, there's at least one setup for an office. You know, right now I'm in our fifth bedroom. We literally converted it to an office. We have a study downstairs, but my husband and I both work. So really two areas is ideal if you can have them set up and make it look nice, not cluttered, you know, not this crazy workspace, but something nice that people would want to work in. And think about the best hotel that you've ever stayed in. If we can create that, you know, using white towels, using light bedding, and a little bit of some color in some accent pillows, but it's just about the whole thing of really setting up a model home. That's our company, by the way, Model My Home here in Dallas. We knew people loved the model home look, and it's like, how do you get that look? Well, you just go back to whenever you've been in like the best hotel or you've visited a model, and what did you love about it? Not too much clutter, but just enough to showcase the space. And, you know, I could go on and on about this because it is my passion. But at the end of the day, you know, make it third grade simple for your sellers as well. And they'll start capturing it. If you can send them before and afters, if you can, you know, allow them to just envision, you know, pictures tell stories. And at the end of the day, this home has to be a model home for somebody. It's a dream home. And so now people are looking online more than ever before. They're doing tours. With our staging, we're going in after we stage. We're still staging vacants. And we're doing a tour walkthrough. Yes, Matterport's good, but we're literally getting our cameras and doing about a 10 to 15 minute walkthrough of the property so that the seller has that now as another value add to be able to show, you know, buyers if they have the request. So you're absolutely right, John. If we give them a list verbally, are they going to do it? And that's the next really step question that I can unpack for you, because we found that when we gave consultations, we gave advice, you know, half of them would do something. They would talk themselves out of the other list. So it's all about like the follow-up of this. And we like to have literally reveal parties. Like, you're going to show us the project, right? We're going to give you the assessment, and then we're going to do a clarity call and walk through the home with you virtually. And then we're going to set up the reveal time that you're going to show. It's show and tell. Show us what you did. That is the solution to these consults, that half the stuff doesn't happen.
I love that. That's a great, you know, accountability piece to schedule. When do you think you can get it done by? You know, we this is kind of what most sellers take a couple days. When do you think you can get it done by? Let's set a show and tell call, or whatever you want to label that call as, and then walking them through that. That is that's fantastic. And obviously this is a great solution if you're not able to get into the home. And you know, one of the things you were saying, you know, envision the hotel, right? Do a little research, you know, pull up some nice hotels online. Pull up some model homes online to get some visuals and get that sent over. I think that is fantastic. So are you seeing, you know, the sellers being really receptive to this process and really getting, it's almost like it's like a seller assist, you know? Are they, you know, getting excited that they get to be part of the process?
We find that we have all types of clients, right? We have the people that are frugal. They want to save money and they're like, hey, tell me, give me a list and I'll do what you need me to. And then we have the clients that do want to be part of, they're like, they're creative and they're kind of, you know, hobbyists. And they're like, we will go in. When we did go in and do these 2-hour touch-ups, we put those on hold right now and we had to pivot to this new service, but we would find it's a lot better and quicker for us if, like, get out of our way, let you go get coffee and come back and we'll just have your home ready for pictures. But people would stay around. They would want to be engaged and part of the process and ask questions. So it's a perfect scenario for those type. If you have clients that really want they're serious about it, they want to help. And then you have the clients that are like, just do it, you know, let me know when it's done. I trust you guys. So we try to assess which type of client we're working with. Do you want to DIY it? Do you want it to be assisted? Or do you want us to come in and it be done for you? And then we can tailor, you know, those packages. So as a listing agent, you guys can find out too, how much willingness they are to work. Give them the short list. And then if you need to have a pro come back in and just finish up and get it like photo ready, that could be, you know, a solution for you guys.
That's fantastic. I mean, since you know, you guys kind of made this pivot, is this a service that you think you guys are going to kind of continue moving forward? Because then now this gives you a broader reach across anywhere, really, actually.
You know, we are counting our blessings of this COVID. It has been a crisis. It's been a crisis for a lot of people, and we don't discredit that. And we're really just trying to see the silver lining. We did not ask for this, but we are saying, how can this allow us to offer more services? And what are our clients needing? You know, and even with virtual staging, we've always felt like it's like nobody wants the virtual agent that you guys are totally, you know, we're all, they don't even need us. Like, we don't want to be that community or that industry that's forgotten, because we believe as long as people are experiencing a property, they need to see it. And these Matterports and all of the tours, they have to have real furniture in them to work. So virtual staging may be a solution for people, but we don't feel like that's going to just take over and be here forever. We feel like as long as people are going to experience the property, staging needs to happen. But we are so open to keeping up these online assessments, these DIY staging projects, you know, the assisted staging, because our clients are loving them. And like you said, it breaks the barriers of location. We can do these. You know, we can do the home in Chicago, from here, from Dallas, and we can understand that. And because of our whole national staging community. We have people, we are partnered with people that are experts in this industry that are just like us here in Dallas, and they're doing the same thing. They're pivoting to more online services.
Yeah, no, it's fantastic. As we were talking through it, I was like, man, this is a great service with your association to be able to offer to, across the country. The other thing, what are you guys recommending how the real estate agent, when they're talking to the seller, how to really set you guys up for success? What is that talk track? Because agents can mess it up, right? And how are you guys coaching them through to how to tee you guys up correctly?
Well, and that's a great point, because you're right. We can work with agents. You know, we love our agents that are our partners in crime here, you know, trying to get every home ready. And we love when they can tee us up and say, okay, we work with Model My Home. They're our preferred, preferred partner. Use who you want, but we have a great track record with them. And what you can expect from them, right? Like, we don't want them pricing out our services.
Correct.
Because, you know, it's a box of chocolates, most houses, and we try to customize. But we want them to just be able to help that seller be confident in the craft, confident that we are not just saying staging, but this is our marketing plan, right? This is our a marketing company that we team with. And you do have to talk with your professional stager to say, what all services do you offer, so that I can make sure that I'm teeing you up properly. So we would love for them to do that introduction and just say, you know, they've got you, they're the experts, and just trust the process, because this is a process, and sometimes it's an ugly process. You have to tear down before you can build up and create that beautiful property. But a lot of times it's super easy, but we don't want them to ever question or doubt the process, because we 100% wouldn't even be in this industry if it didn't work. We believe in it so much. We have thousands. We've helped over 6,000 homes here in Dallas-Fort Worth be ready for market. We have thousands and thousands of success stories. So, you know, it's all about agents being able to believe that in marketing, believe in home preparation. If you want to call it property styling, like, we're styling your property for that ideal buyer based on, you know, the lifestyle look that they're going for. Just tee us up that way and say, you know, they'll work on you with packages that'll be perfect for you. And, you know, here's the worst thing you can do. Here's the worst thing you can do as a listing agent. You can say, you know what, I will help you get the best price for your home stager. And you go then contact 5 or 6 stagers, 3 or 4, whatever, and you are looking for the cheap stager. Because guess what cheap staging will get you? You know, we have seen it. We have heard the horror stories. And, you know, you don't want to just go with the cheap stager, because really the fiduciary responsibility is here is experts work with experts. And the reality is home staging is not a licensed industry. You have all these people trying to, you know, get into the industry. They watch HGTV. They think they're a stager. They order Vistaprint business cards and they're ready to go, yep. You know, and they're charging like $200 to do a vacant stage, and you're going to get a card table with a sheet on top. Like, what's going on? We have never in our history had to restage homes like we did in 2019 and getting into the beginning of this year, because, you know, agents wanted to hire the cheap stager instead of the best stager. So that's the best thing to do. Just tee us up. And we'll go in and we will customize a package that's perfect for their budget and what that home needs.
So you had a great points there that I want to emphasize. One was, you know, just as a listing agent, this is part of our marketing team, and this is the process. And it's just the conveyance of your confidence as a listing agent and being able to just, hey, this is the process. This is what we're going to do to get your home ready for the market. What should agents be looking for in a stager? Like, if they, you know, you said, hey, you got, you know, you know, the cheapest over here, or my buddy's wife or my buddy's friend does staging. Like what should be the credentials? What should you be looking for in a home stager?
Well, what would I look for in a top realtor? You know, if I were to list my property, what am I looking for as a seller? I'm looking for someone that has longevity in the marketplace, that is, the one percenter. They're not an AFA. They're not someone that is just in this business to earn the next dollar. They literally have a passion for it. So I'm gonna Google them. I'm going to find out, you know, I'm going to figure out what their business model is. I'm going to see the history. I'm looking for someone that has been through, they're a professional. And the way, you know, you can see that sometimes this is hard because stagers may use stock photography, you know, and say, oh, well, look at the home that we, and that happens. They're also stealing other stagers' work and putting it on. I mean, there's a lot of stuff we deal with as an association. So, you know, call them, pick up the phone, ask them, all right, you know, how many homes have you staged this year? And the average stager, the average stager, now this luxury homes, we know it's like a luxury agent. You may have fewer listings, but they're luxury. So are they a luxury stager? Do they specialize and be able to hone in their craft on your particular listings? But I want to know how many units they've done. I want to know days on market. I want to know their statistics. I want to know current MLS numbers that they have that are staged on the market. I want to know that they're a team and not some solo stager working out of their home and, you know, pulling stuff out of their own property. Like, that's kind of how a lot of stagers start out, and that's fine. But if I'm an expert advisor, if I'm an expert agent, I want to work with an expert because my name is on the line as an agent. And so I just want to know that there's longevity. I want to know that they're top. They're probably investing in Google AdWords, possibly, or they're at least on the front page. They're more than just a self-starter that has stayed small, but they can do, because here's the problem. Again, that's not, we say, go for it, stager, you know, work your business. But if I'm a top producer and maybe I have a team, I'm going to want someone that can do volume. I don't want to get the call from Sally Stager that just started that says, oh, you know what? I was supposed to be at your property, but the rental truck company wasn't able to come pick up the stuff from my storage unit and I couldn't get out there. There's cancellation. So I want a team that I can trust that has volume and has expertise and experience.
I love that. And so,
and just, I'm sorry, I'm being a little open and real, but
I
you
love
guys
it.
Are,
no, this is, this
you
guys
is, can take it.
This is it. This is what people need to hear. They need to understand with it. I think a lot of agents, and I hear this, you know, frequently, is that, you know, when things are moving so hot, like I put a property on the market and it's multiple offers within, you know, right away. And so they really believe that they don't need staging. Like, share some of the statistics that you guys have seen, and even more so, if the market starts to shift, inventory starts to go up, that value is there. But even more so when they're moving multiple offers in hours or days, like, why is it so important to do staging? And what are some of the statistics that you guys have seen here recently behind it?
Well, we believe professional staging works in any market, no matter if it's a buyer's market, seller's market, soft market. Like, it is the thing to do. It's almost like your proven repeatable system, right? Yep. Like, we've heard that before. There's a reason that we've heard it. It's, you need to have the same home, the selling success system for every single listing, because people want a system. They want to know that it's proven. And so based on your local market, you can look at national statistics. NAR does a study every year. KW does, you know, profile of home staging. And some of those are skewed, but I would say get into your local market, start keeping up with your own statistics, ask your stager, your professional staging company, what their stats are in that local area. For us, we see offer on 50% or more within 2 weeks. We in the local area right here, even in this market, I can't tell you, we have like, I think they had 8 D stages this past week. on the last 5-day period. And we are staging like hotcakes. I mean, it's crazy. The Dallas market has not slowed down for us. And our top producers that we work with, we're having multiple offers. You know, what is this going to look like a month, 2 months down the road? We just had our first Fannie Mae foreclosure that we're staging on Thursday. And we have our first Fort Worth that's in the pipeline too. So, you know, what does that look like? We don't know. But if you have little inventory, don't you want multiple offers? And a professionally staged home is going to attract multiple offers and say, you know, send us your highest and best. If there's so much inventory in the market, don't you want to stand out above competition? So it really has worked. I mean, that's the reason we've been in business for as long as we have, because we've been in the downturns, the upswings, everything. And we've not only survived, but we've thrived because top producers understand that any product, if it wants to sell for top dollar, no matter if it's a car, no matter if it is a piece of furniture, it needs to be in the best condition. You know, it needs to be attractable. That attractability rating has to be so high. And we say it's the four P's, right? It has to be in the right place or location. It has to be priced right. It has to be promoted. And the product has to be just looking amazing. So that's where staging comes in. Once they come in the front door or they experience it online, it's like a first date. We have to get that property ready for a first date, no matter what the market is saying.
I love that. One of the other things that I see agents, you know, kind of mess up, you know, it needs to be a part of your process. If you guys have gone through CHSA, you've gone through any of our stuff, you would understand, you know, the certified home selling advisor, part of that home selling process, you know, proven repeatable system to get your home up to 18% more than traditional real estate agent. That is one of the key components of staging, because it does give you a lift on the value of the property, the perceived value of the property. So it really is a key component. And like I had said, you know, earlier, Jana and her team with Holly at the time, you know, when we were in Dallas, that was one of the key pillars of our process was, I mean, like, when you hire us, you get that, right? We paid for that service because we believe in it so much. So one of the other things that I see agents messing up is not setting the correct timelines for the seller. So kind of talk through here kind of some ideal timelines for the virtual assessment, but also when we're back in the property and we're actually putting our hands on or actually putting, you know, furniture in the home, what are some timelines that as a listing agent should anticipate to where we can set that expectations with the sellers?
Yeah, well, that's a great question as well. And, you know, if we were, and you know, way you coach agents throughout the country, you've done this for years and years, and you've heard all types of processes. And if we were to say, what would be, you know, from my perspective, what do I feel like would be the ideal process? And we've, by the way, sold a ton of homes, my husband and I, and do investment properties, building an Airbnb, and we've always been engaged with realtors in the process. And so here are the agents that stand out to me. You know, we meet at the property, we build the rapport, and they're able to get quick first eyes at a glance. And whether they feel comfortable giving the advice or not, they're going to let us know, you know, that they're bringing in their experts to make sure that the home is prepared well. And so it literally is about getting that listing sealed, doing an initial assessment, like an agent assessment, a high level assessment, and then bringing in the pros to do any type of work. But it all starts with a game plan. You know, it's like the football game. You have to have the great game plan right at the beginning so that we understand what's going to be happening down the line. And so if they understand, it's the education that really sets it all in play. And so the realtors that aren't afraid to just be open and real and say, okay, you know, do I have your permission to be open and real with you and start engaging in the conversation? Homes are a box of chocolates. Many of them need more work than others. And so we get the game plan, we bring the professionals in, and that assessment can happen at a very detailed level with your stagers, whether you call it a consult or an online assessment. And then the sellers have their little short list of things to do. And then the agents can come back, the stagers can come back in, maybe if you need painters and all of that, in that process. And then it's almost like the deadline of the reveal, but we set that deadline at the beginning to understand, okay, these projects need to happen. We anticipate that taking a week and a half. Our ideal date to go live is Thursday, May 1st. And then we're ready for photography, now the video tour, and ready to go live. Whether you want to do a coming soon or not, you know, whatever the strategy is there, but really it is the pipeline. I want to see a system of what to expect, and I want follow-up in that, because if we can get their buy-in at the very, very beginning, they're part of the solution, it's game over, right? I mean, the offers are lining up, but it's not being afraid to have those tough conversations and really set up the game plan, build in your professionals, get that all streamlined, and then have your go live date, your reveal party go live date, whatever you need to do to just put some fun words to get them excited about this. Because for most people, it's not an exciting process.
Right. Absolutely. So are you looking for the agent to really establish the, Hey, Janet, these are my timelines. We go live in 5 days. So you've got to be able to work within this timeline. Or do you like coach them through, hey, ideal timelines for this process? We know especially with virtual, we know they need a couple days. We're going to do our assessment by the time. So, hey, we're better off with 7 days if you can extend that out, kind of an ideal time frame.
We love when we work with our real estate partners, we love for them to let us know the go live date, and know too that, if you're working with a professional staging company and you're expecting furniture to come into the property, then they need probably a 5 to 7 day window. If they're a good company, they're busy. And that's one thing to look for. Make sure that you give them something that is doable. So if you were to then reverse engineer that to say, okay, we want to go live here. When does everybody need to have that plan? If you're building a property, you've got to know what the expectations are. When are my crew showing up? What's happening? It's the same thing with listing a property. We don't just put a sign in the yard and hope for the best. We literally have to think about that plan of action. When's our go live date? And let's reverse engineer this. So when our realtors can give us a call and say, hey, we're going live this day, ideally we can have the assessment done here, the professional staging done here. Does that work for your schedule? Great. We move forward. So the agent is the expert in this, on those timelines.
Yeah, no, it's that's fantastic. That's one of the things that, we love working with you guys all, was always positioning the agent back as the go-to authority. And I think that would be another thing looking for in a stager, is making sure that they understand they're part of the team that makes this work, and not trying to, hog all of the, it's all about me type of process. I think that's fantastic. And, I think back to, I was just thinking through the point that we were talking about from a percentage of, where the home is positioned. And, to the agent out there listening, like, man, I don't need to stage. Homes are bringing multiple offers. Well, no matter what market, there's always the top, there's always the middle, and there's always the bottom. So if you're doing, part of the CHSA process is educating them on that. And so if they choose not to, that could position it in the middle or at the bottom. And so, well, I'm getting multiple offers at asking price. Well, that could be the bottom of the market, right? Whereas if you do the things to position the home in the best possible light, could position it to the top, which could mean above asking price, multiple offers. So I want you guys to understand that the power of making sure that you're doing some type of staging consultation with a true expert is going to allow you to position it top of what you already perceive to be the top of the market. So really take, really make sure that this is dialed in and really a part of your process. Janet, kind of break down for everybody, because I think this would be good for those that listen back through this, if they don't already have a stager, or like what we talked about, what they're looking for. But if they do have a stager, how they can point the stager in your direction of your association, so that they're the best, you know, getting trained, getting coached to be the best at what they do.
Well, that is the good news that, you know, we started this association, we kind of modeled it after NAEA, and you guys, y'all were like our big brothers, and we loved what you guys were doing, and we really caught the vision. And we attracted the top staging companies throughout the country. We have over 100 companies that are part and integrated into our association. They're masterminding with us. We have, you know, resources for them. It's day-to-day business. They are the top. And so if you have a stager that's not part of HSRA, you can just send them to myhsra.com, and they can learn more about what we do and who we are. We would love to help them, even if it's free. Just help them be better, give some resources to them. And, you know, it's all about creating people that you can trust and you can lean on, especially in a time of crisis, right? This is not the time to be partnered with people that are retreating. Like, we have pushed the gas on our business, and we actually love that. We love that we're ahead of the game, and we're rocking and rolling. So, you know, connecting with us is always a great thing, and we'll be able to have those resources for you. And if you are a realtor out there wondering, okay, what's my next? You know, how can I trust, you know, that like staging's kind of an option? I would just say to you, right, this is your brand as well. You're building a real estate brand. And so I don't believe it's a take it or leave it. We have too many success stories. So getting plugged in, seeing what the professionals are doing and following them is always the best route, right? It's like Jay says, you don't have to be the smartest in the room, but you better be sitting next to them, because right, you're going to learn what they're doing. And you guys have been the smartest people in the room. And you know, the agents that aren't part of your group, I don't even understand. They just don't know, you know, they don't know.
Right. Yeah. I lost you there for a second. I'm sure you dropped some nuggets and some value. And you know, really making sure that, you know, not only as an agent, but like your whole team and your stager is part of your team. And making sure that they are getting trained to the best that they possibly can as well. Jana, I don't know if you shared, but what's the best way for people to get plugged in and get connected with you and also get their team connected with you?
Yeah, just myhsra.com. We're the Home Staging and Redesign Association, so we try to keep it simple, myhsra.com. You can definitely send your stagers there if you want them to just, you know, excel. If they're not already part of our family, we would love that. And then we also have Review My Listing. Go to reviewmylisting.com. Maybe you have a home that needs to be reviewed or assessed virtually. You know, it can online, like we can literally assess properties internationally. Then maybe you want somebody to actually walk people through the process, a little DIY. You have some listings that need help, but they can do some things. Then you can also like just send us an email, info@myhsra. We can literally help people from our homes and have those reveal parties, give them some assessments, you know, virtually, so they can help with the process. So, you know, we're just here to help. We are actually going to have our national conference in November here in Dallas at the Irving Convention Center. And we're pivoting that. We're saying it's the Home Staging and Real Estate Summit. So we're integrating realtors in to this, because it is about marketing property. We don't want you to think of us as just home stagers. We're literally your marketing firms that help you get eyes. We have over 10,000 reach here locally. And so whenever we promote those properties, we stage. And by the way, your stagers should be doing the same thing. They shouldn't just be dropping off furniture and moving on. It is their fiduciary responsibility to make sure that home sells for top dollar. So they should be your marketers in this process, your partners in this process, to make sure it gets top dollar. So we're just thankful, and we're excited to be that resource to you guys any way we can.
I love that. And just to, you know, finalize what Jana was saying there, like, we sent our entire team through Jana's training, right? Because it was so important for them to be educated on the process to where they could position the stagers and how important that they are a part of the team and they are the experts and what to say and what not to say. So if you're a seller, if you're a listing agent and you're like, well, I'll get my stager, you know, connected, get yourself connected because you need to be educated. You need to understand the process. It's like, I was talking with one of our clients and it was like, what Russell Brunson talks about is like, even if you have somebody doing that marketing and building your funnels, you need to know what it is so you can tell them what you want. And I thought that was just a fantastic reminder. And it's the same here. It's no different.
Yeah. I mean, that's why I got my real estate license. I wanted to be a subject matter expert. I didn't want to be in production, but I wanted to understand what my agents were going through so that I could serve them better. And that's the same thing. Just learn the information and that helps you be able to communicate it better.
I love it. Jana, you're amazing. Thank you for jumping in and just dropping some nuggets and dropping some knowledge and adding value as you always do. And for all of it, you guys listening in, make sure you connect. Get over to my HSRA connect with Jana and really make sure when you're watching the recording to give some love as well. Jana, thank you so much.
Thank you, John. Thank you, guys. Anytime y'all need anything, just reach out. We'll be here for you.
Awesome. And we'll see you guys on the next episode. See ya.